Last night, something like 125 million Americans and uncounted millions in other countries saw a unique combining of romance and technology. The scientists and engineers looked at the moon and thought they could send men to walk on it if they could build the hardware. It turned out they could, and they did.
Perhaps 50 years from now or more, when people think of the past, they will look at the pictures from last night.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
And to give Artemis teams more time to work through the challenges with first-time developments, operations, and integration, we're going to give more time on Artemis 2 and 3. So what I want to tell you is we are adjusting our schedule to target Artemis 2 for September of 2025 and September of 2026 for Artemis 3. Think back to over 60 years ago when President Kennedy went about 20 miles from where we are now to Rice Stadium, and he made that famous speech, "We choose to go to the moon and do other things, not because it's easy, but because it's hard."
The Eagle has wings.
We're committed to launching as safely as possible.
100 feet, 3.5 down, 9 forward.
And we will launch when we're ready.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
That's one small step for man, one giant leap for mankind.
How is the quality of the TV?
Oh, it's beautiful, Mike, really is.
Is the lighting halfway decent?
Yes, indeed. They got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the lunar surface.
Hello, Neil and Buzz. I'm talking to you by telephone from the Oval Room at the White House.
Beautiful. 26, 36 feet per second up. 5 for the pitch over.
We are facing challenges, both technical and just dealing with going back to the moon. The need for propellant transfer, the need for numerous landings. We're looking at our spacesuits that we're acquiring in a different manner that we've done before and developing the new spacesuits as well. And as I and others have said and will continue to say, we'll launch when we're ready.
We're also adding advanced spacesuits. Each one of these spacesuits is an individual spacecraft for the crew.
The curtains have been drawn. There they are in the rear window. The president signaling for applause from the crowd. Astronauts gather in the window.
And, many other people in many places have speculated on the meaning of this first landing on another body in space. Would each of you give us your estimate of what is the meaning of this to all of us?
Entire program. It's a beginning of a new age.
Not everybody can be a robot polisher.
You know, can you talk a little bit about the confidence that we should have in a 2026 launch date for Artemis 3? You know, this date has moved from 2028 to 2024 to 2025, now to 2026. And, you know, you talk to people in the industry and they don't feel like that's really realistic given all of the work that Amit described, that you described, Jim, that we've got ahead of us. And kind of walk me through your confidence in that date, because it does not seem to be consistent with what I'm hearing in industry.
See, the fall of 2026, the September 2026 timeframe, is still very aggressive.
Remember what I said at the outset. We don't fly until it's ready. Safety is paramount. So whether we fly in September of 26 and land, regardless of your question about China, we don't fly until it's ready.